Hi all, welcome to the screencast. I am Hasanthi Disanayake, a senior software engineer at WSO2. This screencast is WSO2 Identity Server 580, which is the latest version we released just a few days ago. I will discuss what's new in version 580. In this release, there are two new features: OpenID Connect Back Channel Logout and SAML Front Channel Logout. Apart from that, this contains some major improvements, number of bug fixes, and performance improvements. Let's discuss the new features in detail. Previous identity server versions support OpenID Connect Logout by using session management, which uses user agent for communication. OpenID Connect Back Channel Logout feature allows login out users from the reliant party using direct communication with client and server. This method is very reliable as it is independent from user agents. The logout request does not depend on the reliant party's browser session actively. The SAML 2 specification defines two bindings for single logout profile, as asynchronous binding, which is front channel logout, and synchronous binding, which is back channel logout. So far, WSO2 identity server supported SAML back channel logout. From 580 onwards, it supports SAML front channel logout as well. In SAML front channel logout, the session participants use an asynchronous binding such as HTTP redirect binding, HTTP post binding, or artifact binding to send a request to the identity provider through the browser agent. There are a number of feature improvements done with version 580. Let me highlight a few. Product observability. This feature enables rapid debugging of product issues by logging the time taken for LDAP and JDBC calls. Scheme 2 improvements. Some major improvements are done to the scheme pagination and filtering. There are plenty of feature improvements, including configuring X509 authentication with SSL termination and support recapture for username and password recovery. All the other improvements are listed here in the WSO2 Identity Server documentation. This graph represents the comparison of version 570 and version 580, and it displays response times taken for some major scenarios in WSO2 Identity Server. Comparatively, for the most of the scenarios, a lower response time can be noticed in version 580. Why version 580? There are a number of reasons to use Identity Server 580. It contains number of bug fixes, so the stability of the product is increased. Few new features and some major improvements are introduced in this release, but it contains very less schema changes. Further, the users can seamlessly migrate from version 570 with few configuration changes. One of the main important things is the performance improvements. When comparing with 570, the performance is increased in the major flows. We invite you all to play with version 580. You can go to the WSO2 site and download the product and refer WSO2 Identity Server documentation. We are fully open source, so we really appreciate your contribution to WSO2 Identity Server. If you encounter with any issue, please report it or drop us a mail. We hope you will enjoy with our latest product. Thanks for watching.